me share with you some of my ideas on this issue. And I'm speaking on behalf of myself as one of the leaders of the Islamic movement in the Arab world.
Who's after Ibrahim Mogra?
Yes, Islam is for peace. And yes, we are hoping for global unity. But let me be different from the other speakers who have emphasized this without any reservation. Let me put some reservations, major reservations, on this. Today, there is a huge injustice going on in the world. And although there is only one superpower in the world today, but we are further from peace and unity than we have been before. We as Muslims are very proud of our religion, are very proud of our heritage. We as Muslims have led civilization for a long period of time. And when we led civilization, we created unity and we created peace. Christians and Jews were living in Palestine, in Palestine and Jerusalem, in peace and unity. It is when others governed that we had torture and we had people being cleansed. Muslims are not living in peace under the occupation in Palestine. We Muslims, whenever we ruled, we provided peace and freedom of religion, freedom of speech for everyone. When Muslims ruled Egypt, for example, no church was touched. When Muslims ruled Palestine and Jerusalem, every sacred place for the Christians was preserved until today. But when others ruled, unfortunately, they did not deal with us in the same way. And we have been backward. We have been backward for a long period of time. For about 400 to 500 years, we have been backward. And especially in the past century, we have been occupied. 1 million people were killed in Algeria alone, in Algiers alone. Muslims were killed all over, in Kashmir, in Palestine, in Spain, in so many areas we were killed. It is only Islam, when you look through history, it is only under the rule of Islam that the world had peace and freedom of religion and speech. Today, we in the Muslim world and we in the Arab world are coming back to our deen, to our religion, to Islam. Wherever you go, I have been from Vancouver to Australia, and I've seen the Islamic revival everywhere, whether it's a Muslim country or there are Muslim minorities. Everywhere Muslims are coming back to their religion, to their deen. And when we look, alhamdulillah, this revival is not something that has happened in the past in the usual way. Now we have Islamic banks, Islamic media, Islamic organizations, Islamic women programs and women institutions, children programs, and in every area of life we are coming back. We are coming back to lead society and lead civilization as we led it before. We are positioning ourselves to be a superpower of the world again. That is what we are after. I have talked to the intellectuals and politicians in the United States. And I have talked in behalf of the Islamic movement. I have said the following, and the same message I would like to pass to the politicians and to the media in UK. Islam is coming back to power. In every country of the world, you see Islam is either in power or next line in power. We in the Islamic movement are extending our hands to the West. We are extending our hands. Let's have a dialogue. Let's respect each other. We can benefit a lot from the West. The West has advanced so much. They are definitely more advanced than us when it comes to management, to technology, to many areas. They are more advanced from us. We need to learn from them, and we are willing to learn from them. But the West also needs us. The West is corrupt when it comes to family values, to morality. The West needs Islam. We are in the Islamic movement. We are extending our hands to the West. The West is doing a lot of injustice to the Islamic world. They claim freedom. They claim democracy. But whenever they see an Islamic movement coming into power, they would suppress freedom and they would suppress democracy. Is that the kind of unity that we want in the world? Is that the global unity that we're after? Let the people choose, and you will see that Muslims will choose only Islam. We would like the example of Muslims in the UK to be applied to the Muslim world, where there is democracy, where Muslims and everyone is free to choose whoever they want to represent them. And we are sure in the Islamic movement that they will choose us, because we are working not for ourselves, but for our deen, for Islam. Look at the example of Algiers. Look at the example of Egypt in the past few days. Look, and you see the choice of the people. It is dictators that are supported by the West that are stopping us from advancing and having global unity and peace. We would like this example, this gathering of Muslims where they can talk freely, can be done only in the West. We are not allowed to do it in our countries. And our dictators are supported by the West to suppress Islam and the Islamic movement. Brothers and sisters, congratulations. You became part of this society, and you have put your stamp on this society. You have reached a level where this government have respected you, and the ministers would come and to talk to you because they know your power, and your power is in adhering to your religion and voting together, united. We would like, frankly, truly, we would like this example to move to our countries. So many Muslims in the Muslim world long and love to be able to do what you're doing today, where they can get together freely without the secret police taking them into prisons. We would like this example that Muslims can get together in many areas, in many places in the Muslim world. Muslim sisters cannot even wear hijab in the Muslim world. So congratulations, brothers and sisters. You have gone a long way. And we in the Muslim world, look unto you as an example to represent Islam and to build a bridge between us and the West. And you are the most able to do it.